I experienced. So we'll have some readings. I want to talk to him about his life. He's here today. Stay tuned. I think it's worthwhile. We'll be back with George Anderson after this. Stay right there.
Hi, I'm Steve. This is Kathy.
Oh, and we just love Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
Frosted Flakes are about so much more than just great taste. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's that, and then there's Tony, you know. Mm-hmm. Then there's the frosting, and then there's Tony.
No, take a picture.
Okay, got it. Okay. He looks different.
I think that's a woman.
You're right.
Yeah.
They're great.
Where can you find your favorite Kellogg's breakfast mate? Right next to the milk, of course.
What is the best detergent for getting rid of bacteria in your laundry? New Tide with bleach. The only detergent that kills 99.9% of bacteria. The rounded applicator.
How Stephanie Becker eats a Reese's peanut butter cup.
Oh, I like to eat one of my Reese's right away and save the other one for later. Just later.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
Mother's Day is almost here. Why not treat her to a Dairy Queen frozen cake? Don't forget graduation.
If you can't make it to Pennsylvania Dutch Country for dinner, you can still join us for dessert. Turkey Hill Ice Cream, imported from Lancaster County.
WCBS-TV maintains reports concerning its educational and informational programming for children in its public file at 524 West 57th Street, New York, New York, 10019. Interested persons may inspect these reports during regular business hours. Wake up with Cindy Hsu, Kendra Farn, and Ira Joe Fisher, weekday mornings at 5:30. Tonight on News 2 at 5, the mysterious shooting of innocent pets leaves one town stuck. We'll have the latest in the search for the gunman. Then Monica Lewinsky out on the town in New York City, but last night the cops were called into her favorite late-night hangout. News 2's Pablo Guzman tells you why. And blow Mom's mind on Mother's Day with a cruise on the QE2, and it won't cost a fortune. We'll have all the details. Plus, Mark Dannon with your Mother's Day weekend forecast. Tonight on News 2 at 5.
And I'm devoting this entire show to a man who hopefully you'll never forget. I have never forgotten since I met him. He's actually a friend. He became a friend. And he's a gifted man with an incredible power. Please welcome George Anderson. Story, so there's nothing new. We don't even have to talk, really.
But I want to ask you. Hopefully, left the scandal out.
The scandal. I left it all out.
Oh.
But it is fascinating to me. So you were born normal, right? You were born. You had no.
As far as we know.
As far as you know. But before you were 6 years old, this is 6 years old when you had the encephalitis.
Yeah.
Okay. Before 6 years old, you never saw a vision or had an imaginary friend or heard voices.
No, not that I recall.
Not that you recall. So when you woke up from coma, like to say, or when you woke up that morning after the brain had, the swelling had gone, what happened? The brain swell?
Well, they actually thought I was going to pass on. And
right.
I remember losing the use of my legs. You know,
you actually were hurt.
Yeah, it was for a time being. I remember crawling, learning how to walk again.
Right.
And I remember my mother had carried me into the bathroom.
Right.
And actually, I remember standing up in front of the toilet and saying, oh, I can stand up again. So apparently...
Which was a miracle. Doctors didn't think that
would happen. Yeah, they thought I was on the way out.
So how soon after that did you hear a voice or see a vision?
Probably not that long after. And, of course, you know, at 6 years old, the worst thing that happens is the family say, oh, did you stop with the fantasies already? And stuff?
Right, but I have a six-year-old, and she mm-hmm. sees imaginary mm-hmm. friends or talks about somebody who's mm-hmm. not there. So when did you first realize that this was, or did you, that this was different, or everybody doesn't see
Well, it? No, it always seemed extremely natural, which even to this day it does. It just is the natural state of being. But I can recall then, you know, through the years, not much was paid attention to, but at the age of 14, became more precise.
But when you say it's natural, do you, as you're sitting here now, do you hear, are you hearing voices and you're just
no.
not answering them?
No. Again, it's like any job. When you know you have to do it, I consider it a vocation. When you know you have to do it, you have to do
but
it.
But you didn't have to do it at six, so these visions and voices were coming to you uncontrollably.
Yeah, it must have just been on its own at that point, and maybe because it was more acceptable at that point because of being that age.
And your thought or your reasoning for this is because with the encephalitis, that part of your brain might have been damaged, right?
They have theorized that, yes.
Yes, so
part of the brain might have died.
Right.
And thus another part of the brain was forced to heal itself. They did have, I think it was on 2020, they had a segment on about a young woman, a young child who had epilepsy.
Right.
It was doing extreme damage to the brain, but it actually was performed some sort of surgery where they were able to, like, force the right part of the brain to take over everything.
Well, I think with epilepsy, I've seen a piece on that where they actually cut out a portion
yes,
of the brain
exactly.
that is causing the problem.
Right.
So therefore, you're using a portion of the brain that we don't know about or is probably not used before. And
that's what they think. I could be using a greater percentage of the brain than the average person. When I had the EEG experiments done, the doctor was surprised at the fact that the area that lights up in my head only when I'm discerning is what they call, I think, the front lobal region. And
right.
ironically, it's known as the dead zone.
Because usually
we don't use it.
Because nobody uses it. So they mm-hmm. like, speaking of the experiments, I talked earlier about the experiments. When they started testing this, some of the experiments, I talked about the EEG.
Yes.
Your brain waves register, when you are discerning, your brain waves register different than a regular person would.
Right. What happened is that while I was discerning,
right.
The EEG would show that I was in the dream state. And then
right.
when I'd say they're leaving or I'm going to stop, I would go up to the normal awake.
And you will also see later on, because we will have him read some people, that he isn't in the dream state. I mean, I can still, while you're discerning and while people
mm-hmm.
are coming over from the other side, I can converse with you like I'm
right.
conversing with you now. So you aren't asleep. So
right.
it is a definite register. And the other test that was amazing was it thermography?
Yes.
Thermography. And
that was the first one that I had done.
And these are done by medical doctors,
yes.
not people who believe in ESP. These are
oh, no.
good
these
medical
are
doctors.
By,
what they done. Did was, do you want to explain it? Do you want me to explain it?
Well, the thermography actually was, I'll never forget, it was a freezing cold day in New York City, and it was a Swiss doctor who I had to strip down to nothing but a swimsuit.
Right.
And I had to stand in this temperature-controlled room for a period of time. And, of course, the outside temperature was extremely cold. It was the middle of winter, so the temperature of the room was really dropping.
But and they put you behind a screen, because I saw a piece of it. Okay, they put you behind
yeah.
a screen that kind of registers. Have you ever seen those infrared glasses where that night goggles? So you can see if heat is being emitted from any portion of the body more than usual.
Yes.
And then they put people who had specific ailments
mm-hmm.
behind a scrim,
right.
behind some sort of screen. When you talk to the person that had a problem with his brain,
mm-hmm.
and would you be talking to somebody from the other side who would be telling you this? Somebody
I seem to remember there would be people from the hereafter that would be saying it, but you would also just sense.
When you would sense there
was
a problem, without them telling you anything,
right.
then you would see that your brain would heat up.
Right. Or
right.
a certain part of the body actually would heat up.
Right. But that correlated with what the problem was
exactly
with the person behind the
yes.
screen. Now, when you were going through all this testing, you realized you could do it. You're a skeptic yourself,
yes.
aren't you? You didn't think that you were like psychic or...
No, I actually agreed to a number of the experiments because I wanted to find out exactly what was happening. That if it weren't for real, we'd find out that it's not for real. And on the other hand, if it were for real, would I be able to enhance it or utilize it better? But after a period of time, I started to find out that the ability works best in helping people cope with their loss.
Well, did you always think this was a gift, or were you, like, at 14, did you think it was a gift, or did you think you were
No, again, it just seemed to be a natural ability. And I would actually call it an ability, a mediumistic ability, because, I mean, we all have gifts. We have gifts for what you do with comedy and such, but we're all blessed in our own unique way, even if we don't know it. And now the ability works best when it's used to to help people cope with their grief. It doesn't cure grief, but it helps people cope with it. It gives them a sense of hope, reassurance, and comfort. And it took me years to find out what niche would be best for me to utilize the ability in. And I find that that's where it is definitely.
Speaking of the ability, we're going to have you do some readings here today so we can hear from the other side. And I'm also going to want to talk to you about what the messages are, what it's like on the other side. And there seems to be a strong message that they are trying to give us that seems to be a way, a real good path to follow. So you stay right here, you stay right there, and I'll be back with George Anderson and some other people from the other side right after this. There we are.
Close captioning for the Howie Mandel Show is brought to you by...
At Good Neighbor Pharmacy, we get questions about pain relief. Next time you're in, ask about Advil, Advanced Medicine for Pain. Get 25% more free.
It's Ray Romano and family on Hollywood Squares.
Can a gorilla swim?
You can get a gorilla to swim. The hardest part is getting him into a studio.
Everybody loves Raymond in Hollywood Squares.
Tonight at 7:30 on CBS 2.
Donald Quentin Merman?
Yeah.
Mr. Merman, you represent the Sports Fan Alliance. I'm afraid we have some bad news for you. We're letting you go.
What?
You're not watching the game.
Yeah, I've been meaning to get cable.
Take it away, boys. We're replacing you with another guy. Want some more. He's got cable business. Been watching the Yankees, Knicks, Nets, Rangers.
Yeah, but I love my team, too. What are we doing Monday night?
Watching a cooking show.
This is what I'm talking about. Show him what he's missing.
Sign up for Cablevision and watch all your favorite teams on MSG Network, Fox Sports Net New York, ESPN, and more. Call 1-888-422-2832 and installation's only $9.95. That's right, $9.95. Just call 1-888-422-2832.
Install for $9.95? Really?
All you had to do was call. What a waste.
Hey, that's my mailbox. Hey,
tonight on Mama Palooza Friday, just in time for Mother's Day, kids pay tribute to their favorite lady. Don't miss a special full hour, all new Kids Day. Then, can three of TV's favorite moms rule a Mother's Day conference?
Is she the Richie Beaver's mother?
A special all new full hour of candid camera. And San Francisco's crack detective unit.
You've had your run.
It's shut down.
This is all your fault.
Get out of my park, Cross, or I'll bust you for soliciting.
All new Nash. It's all tonight on CBS Mama Palooza Friday.
Each year, 30% of adults over the age of 65 are injured by falling down. However, a few simple precautions can help reduce the risk of falling in your home. Make sure there are wide enough spaces to walk through all around your home. Good lighting is important, and so is safeguarding your bathroom and shower with stabilizing fixtures. Don't be embarrassed to use a walker or a cane, and take your time when moving around. Be careful, and don't let the fear of falling keep you from enjoying life. I'm Dr. Ira Nash.
Good job.
Get the keys. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
Back, and we're talking to medium George Anderson about his new book, Lessons from the Light. And I have here Goldie, our lovely conductor from the Studio One Band. And we're going to do some readings today because we want to learn the lessons from the light. And you've volunteered to be read by George.
Right.
And before we read, I want to show the people at home, not the people here, because I don't want George to hear it, a little bit of the background of your life to see how many points George will actually get from the other side. Watch this. Steve Goldstein is our band leader. He lost his mother, Peggy, just last year, and 10 years ago lost his father, Matt. Before her passing, Peggy had limited use of the right leg, making it very difficult for her to get around, and she eventually succumbed to cancer. So that's Steve Goldstein, and George, go ahead and start.
Okay, before we begin, just, of course, I'd like to testify in camera, you've never spoken to me in any way, shape, or form until this day, and of course, I've never spoken to you, although, how do you do?
Nice to meet you.
Thank you for being here. Also, when I need you to acknowledge that yes, know that you understand only. Don't go into details or information or elaborate on anything. And let's see what happens. This is just done as a form of distraction. I don't want you to think anything mysterious is happening.
Okay, well, first of all, a female presence comes near to you, and a male also. Somebody says dad, do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so your dad is here. Who embraces you with love. He talks about his mom being with him, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
But his mom has passed on. Also, your dad called out mom, do you understand? Your mom is here? Your mom has passed on. Because your dad said your mom is here, meaning
right.
With him.
Right.
And that's the female presence he came up to initially. So she was the first one here wanting to get credit for that. And then your dad followed, and then your father said something about his mom is here, but both your parents are together. Your father didn't believe in a hereafter?
You don't know.
I don't believe he did.
It almost seems that his attitude might have been, we'll find out when I'm dead. You know, that sort of thing.
He's fairly pragmatic.
But yet your parents were spiritual people
mm-hmm.
in their own right. There's another flock of people around you. I just want to get pious claim to be grandparents. I'm sure they've all passed on. But your mom draws very close to you, so I take it you and she were close.
Yes.
She also blesses you for being good to reply to her passion. And your mother's not a religious woman, but she is a spiritual woman in her own right. You do pray for her in your own way,
mm-hmm.
which she does thank you for, asking her to please continue.
Your mother gives me the feeling she's been over there for a while, is that true?
Well, long enough to know her way around, let's put it that way. Because she seems very, like, adaptable. She might have also wondered what's going to happen after passing, but that's all right. I keep saying the name Rose. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Don't say who it is, but do you understand?
Yes, she is.
Okay, passed on, though. Because her mother keeps saying Rose is with me. There's a motherly feeling with her, like it's her aunt or something. She's coming in like she's there with her mom. Your mom also blesses you for being good to reply to her passing. Also emphasizes that you didn't let her down, in case you had that concern. She also says she's walking fine, which either means she has trouble with the legs or she's back to her old self. She's telling me she's walking fine, so do you understand?
I do.
Okay, as long as you understand, that's all I need to know. Now, your mom also called out the family, so I assume, like, you have brothers, sisters, whatever, calling out the family down here on the earth, because she seems to be a very family-oriented woman. Now, I do see the Star of David in front of me, so I take it your mom was Judaic?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Uh-huh. Now I know why. I'll explain in a few minutes. And again, she wasn't bung-ho in Judaism, but she was spiritual.
Yes, spiritual.
That's the thing. That's the key word. Yeah, she admits she had a rough time prior to her passing, but she's back to her old self. Kind of jokes with me that in the hereafter she's on the vacation she never really got. Because she says she has not the easiest life on the earth. Maybe she has a hard-working life, but she has a very fulfilling life. Also, her name's Sarah, too. Do you understand? Surround your mom, hungrily, which it sounds like either Sarah or became Sadie.
Right.
It makes sense? Okay, as long as you understand, because your mother's talking, she seemed to say Sarah, and when you didn't know, she said, no, change it to Sadie.
Right.
So this is probably to cue you that you'll know exactly who she's talking about. And that individual being there with her as well, and again, there's a family feeling, so of motherliness for that reason as well. Yeah, your mom, you feel like you didn't do enough for her, and she says you did. You know that you love her and she loves you. That's all you should be worried about. Your dad also feels he could have been a little closer to you. That's true?
Mm-hmm.
He seems to have a better relationship with your mother. But your father wants you to know that he always loved you, even if he might have had a strange way of showing it. He seems to have been kind of there and not there. But his heart's in the right place. He might have seemed a little on demanding side.
both of them are expressing pride in what you have achieved and what you have become. And your mom claims to be around you like as a guardian angel, and I don't think you'll be the least bit surprised to hear that. And also,
can you tell us, Mom, that we've got 20 seconds till we go to a commercial?
Okay, then I'll use that 20 seconds. Is it okay if I get up?
Go ahead.
Okay, because before I left Long Island, I was impressed to bring this with me, and now I know why. And this, no doubt, is a gift from your mom, who impressed me to get that for you, that you'll know she's always with me.
Okay.
Sure.
Now, this is amazing. Because there's something that matches this symbol from my mother's apartment that passed on last year. This hand, the same symbol that's on this box. I took it from her apartment, but it's in my home now. And I'm from Long Island.
Really?
Yeah, this is